Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Hello everybody, today we are going to start with the second part of the poem Television. We were already doing this thing in the last class. It is for the class 10's ICSE exams. It is written by Roald Dahl. It is a very simple poem, quite easy for all of you to understand. Even if you are not an ICSE student, you can obviously follow the class. So, in the first part of the poem, we learned that the poet is completely against watching television. He feels that it is harmful if you watch a lot of television. It has a negative impact on your imagination, on your mind. Now, he says that obviously people have started watching television for a particular reason, that when the children are watching television, they sit quietly in a particular place instead of disturbing their parents. So the parents might ask that if we take away the television set and not let them see or watch television for a long time, then the children will go on disturbing them, would not allow the parents to do their work. So what would they do instead when they are removing the television set? Then what should they do instead of that? So the poet gives them a remedy or another way for it. What is it? He says, "Great Scott, gadzooks!" This is an exclamation. Exclamation means just like this phrase. That just imagine when we were small, that means when there was no television set, when the television was not invented even, then what did the children do? Even then there were small children who had to enjoy their lives. How did they enjoy their lives? One half their lives was reading books. That means we have divided the life of a person into four parts. When it is childhood, then comes adolescence, then we are in our adulthood, and then old age. So the first part of our life is childhood. In that period of time, when there was no television, children used to do what? They used to read a lot of books. Okay. The nursery shelves held books galore. Galore means in a huge number, there were books in the shelves. Okay. Books cluttered. Cluttered means when you read a lot of books, you take one book from the shelf and you read it and you keep it aside. Again, you take another book. So the books are not arranged in the shelf. It is all on the floor because you have read a lot of books. So it is all over the nursery floor. There are books in the bedroom also, beside the bed. There were more books waiting to be read. So the children had access to a huge number of books. There were different kind of books. Adventures, then the distant shores, there were islands, there were pirates. There were so many things that the children had access to. They could read. What were those books all about? Such wondrous, fine, fantastic tales. You know that the words written in red are the meanings of the difficult words. So, tales means stories. So, the children used to read fantastic, beautiful stories about what? About dragons. You know, dragons who spit fire. There were gypsies. Gypsies are the ones who are free-spirited nomads, just like these people. They do not have a permanent home. They wander from one place to the other and they sell certain things to earn a living, but they just move around from one place to the other. They do not have a home like we have. Next, what were the stories about? There were stories about the queens and the whales and treasure isles. Isles means islands. So there are treasure islands, stories about the treasure islands, distant shores, faraway shores where you can find hidden wealth, your hidden treasure. There were adventures of Tom Sawyer, and so many stories were there that they used to read at those times. When there was no television set, they had a huge amount of time to do certain things, and then they used this time to read books. Where smugglers, now there are other books also. There are books about smugglers, the traffickers. Who are smugglers? These are people who sell certain things to other places, you know, illegally. They are not allowed to do that, but they do it illegally. So there were smugglers who rowed with muffled oars. Muffled oars means these are bad people. So they will not just take the boat and set sail in front of everybody. They will hide, and in the middle of the night, they will set out with their ships or boats. So there are stories about them also. What else? And pirates wearing purple pants. So there, see, this is an alliteration. Pirates, purple pants. So there are stories about pirates also. You know, these ships you have seen, I think there is a movie, Pirates of Caribbean. You know, these are the ships. These are the, you know, you have thieves on land also, robbers. Just like we have robbers on the land, we have pirates in the sea. When ships travel from one place to the other, rich ships travel from one place to the other, these pirate ships attack them and steal everything from their ships. So these are sea robbers. Okay. And sailing ships and elephants. So there are stories about ships and elephants also. What else? And cannibals. What are cannibals? Cannibals are those people who eat the flesh of other people. Okay. Crouching round the pot. So we see few people who are preparing or cooking something in this pot, and they are all sitting beside the pot waiting for the dish to be prepared. Okay, hungrily, and they are also stirring away at something hot. They are using a spoon to stir something inside the pot. Now, this makes us imagine, isn't it? We start imagining that what could be inside this pot. There must be something inside the pot that is being cooked that may be human flesh also, that may be tasty also, isn't it? It smells so good. What can it be? So cannibals are cooking this food. What can it be? Will it be human flesh? Is it tasty? We start thinking. Good gracious, it's Penelope. So see, these are rhyming words, Penelope and can it be. All these words are rhyming, hot and pot. So these are rhyming words. Next, the younger ones. Now, the stories about the cannibals, the stories about smugglers, these are for children who have grown up a bit. But there are younger ones also. There were younger children also who were very small. There were books for them also. There were books written by Beatrix Potter. Beatrix Potter used to write stories for children, and the characters were all animals. Okay. There were Now there is a book, The Wind in the Willows, which is written for the children, and all the characters over here, you can see a frog. This is also another character in the story. So all the characters of the story are animals. There is Mr. Tod, the Dirty Rotter, the Squirrel Nutkin, Pigling Bland, Mrs. Tiggy Winkle, and just how the camel got his hump. Now, what does these stories contain? There are stories about how the camel got the hump. What is a hump? Hump is the thing that you see at the back of the camel. Okay, so there are stories about that because they are small children. They come to know about all that from the books. Now, there are stories about how the monkey lost his rump. That means how the monkey lost the tail that it had. Okay. Mr. Toad and bless my soul, there is Mr. Rat and Mr. Mole. So there are stories about all that also. Oh, books, what books they used to know, those children living long ago. So long ago, they used to read so many books. They used to know so many things which we do not have access to anymore because the whole time we spend watching stupid show in the television. So please, oh please, we beg, we pray, go throw your television set away. So what is the poet suggesting to the parents? That you just go take the television set and throw it away because it is harmful. And in its place, you can install a lovely bookshelf on the wall. So what you can do is, in the place of the TV, the LCD screen that you see, just removing that, you will get an empty space. In that space, put a bookshelf and put a huge number of books in it so that the children can have an access to those books and can get interested and start reading books from here. Then fill the shelves with lots of books. So first you put the shelf and then fill the shelf with a number of beautiful books for them. Okay, age appropriate books. Ignoring all the dirty looks. You can be asked, what do you mean by dirty looks? Dirty looks means the dirty looks of the children. The children will be very annoyed. If imagine you have a television set at home, you watch your cartoons, you watch a number of shows over there, and suddenly the television set is removed. You'll be very angry. You will be looking very angrily at your parents. So those will be dirty looks. The screams and yells, the bites and kicks, the children hitting you with sticks. Now the children will be very angry. They will be doing naughty things. They will start hitting you. They will be crying. Because we promise you that in about a week or two of having nothing else to do, but parents, you need not be afraid, because in a week or two, the children will have nothing else to do. They will not have the television set to waste their time. So they will now begin to feel the need of having something to read. So now they will have a lot of free time because they do not have the television set to waste the time. So they will start reading. And once they start, oh boy, you watch the slowly growing joy. Now slowly the children will realize the importance of the books, the importance of using your mind to think. You are a human being. Why are you a superior creature? Better than the animals, because you have the power to think. So you have to use your brain. If you are not using your brain, then you are not a superior creature, isn't it? That fills their hearts. They will grow so keen, that means they will grow so interested in those books that they will wonder what they have ever seen in that ridiculous machine. So they themselves will realize that this television set is a stupid thing. They were wasting time in nonsensical stuff. That nauseating, foul, unclean, repulsive. Repulsive means arousing disgust. That television screen only arouses disgust in them now. Why? Because they have realized that wasting time in television, wasting time in watching those stupid shows makes you stop using your brain. It makes you lose your capability to imagine. And later, each and every kid will love you more for what you did. Now, afterwards, the children will themselves realize and they will thank the parents for removing the television set. Because if the television set was still there, then they wouldn't have been interested in the books. If the parents had not removed the television set and installed the bookshelf over there, they would never have realized the importance of books. And they would never have grown the love for the books. Okay? So over here the chapter ends and we will start with the rest of the figure of speech. In the first class also we have discussed some figure of speech. This is the last one. Figures of speech first is alliteration. I've already told you it is a repetition of consonants twice or more than two times in a particular line. So consonants means in this line see C, C, C is being repeated twice in a line. So therefore it is an alliteration. If the question comes that what type of poem is this, you will say this is a didactic poem. What do you mean by didactic poem? It is a poem where the poet tries to teach people certain things, teaches people about what to do and what not to do. In this poem, we are told that if you watch television, you will lose your imagination. You should not waste your time in that way. You should read more books to develop your imagination, your creative power. Okay, that is why the poet here teaches us certain things, and that is why it is a didactic poem. The last thing that we are going to do from here is the main themes of the poem. We are going to discuss that. The first one is, these questions are very important, please be very careful. Television and idiot box. If you are told to explain why the poet thinks in such a way, what will you say? The central idea of the poem is that television is an idiot box that clogs and freezes the mind of young children. It distorts your mind, it clogs, just like a water pipe is clogged and water cannot flow. In the same way, all those trash, all those bad things that gets into your head after you watch that stupid show, it will waste your mind away. You will not be able to think better, create better. The idiot box has a transferred epithet. What do you mean by transferred epithet? Transferred epithet means when you use the adjective of one noun in some other place. The television is not idiot, isn't it? The television itself is not an idiot or is not a stupid person. But the people who watch the television for long hours, their minds will be wasted and they will become dull and just like an idiot. Okay, so that is what is written over here, that it is not the television set that is an idiot, but if it is watched for long hours, it has a capability to turn the children dull and incapable of imagination. Next, television for dull is not only an idiot thing, but also a monster. Second thing is, he also calls the television set a monster. Why? Because just like a monster can hypnotize children and take them away into bad places, in the same way, the television set also can hypnotize children and fill their minds with junk, with bad waste material. Children, when you have filled a place with waste material, can you put anything else in that place? No. In the same way, when your mind or brain is full of bad material, waste material, you have no other place to put put things that is better. In the same way, the monster also distorts and fills your mind with junk. Children while watching television do not engage themselves actively in thinking, and such passivity makes them dull. They do not think, they just go on watching. They stare at the TV and they go on watching it, and nothing, their mind is not working. And that is most important. Children's minds are most creative and they must work. So the second most important thing is, kills imagination dead. This is important. Question can come from here. See, imagination is a creative faculty. If you want these, you can just pause the video and copy these down. Okay, it will help you in your exam. Imagination is a creative faculty that helps us to form a picture. If you are still following me, if you are listening my video, then please hit the subscribe button and also press the bell icon. That helps us to form a picture in our minds of something that we have experienced or thought about. So it, whatever we are thinking, our creative faculty, it is wasted if you go on watching those waste. Watching too much television destroys the children's abilities to create or understand the world of fantasy, the beautiful world, the world of imagination. All that is wasted if you watch a lot of TV. What will happen? Your thinking power will rust and freeze just like a metal. Okay? And then it will not help you in working. Last thing that we are going to do from here is the importance of reading books. That is what the poet suggests us to do, and that is what will be the last topic. The poem stresses the importance of inculcating reading as a habit. This is an important line. The poet says that you will have to introduce to yourself the interest in reading. You must be interested in reading. As you go on reading more books, then you will grow your interest, isn't it? Just one day you sit with a book and you are very interested. This will not happen. You have to sit, you have to read one page, then you go again, do your work, again you come back to read the next page. This way you will slowly grow your interest. For Dell, it is only reading that can fill children with true joy and happiness. Reading books will help them to travel to new and exciting worlds of dragons, gypsies, queens and whales. All that is already told in the poem, that when you read books, you get close to so many things, so many wonderful things. Dragons, spitting fire, gypsies, going to strange places, different adventures, queens, whales. Dell remembers his days when television was not invented and children used to spend their time reading. When there was no television, the children used to spend a lot of time in reading books, and that was the best days according to Dell. Children will surely thank their parents sooner or later for introducing them to books and throwing away the monstrous television set when they understand the beautiful world books can provide. When these children will realize, sooner or later they will surely realize, that instead of wasting time in looking at the television set, it was far better to read books. Then these children will be very happy for what their parents had done by removing the television set. So I think this part is very easy. This poem is not at all difficult for you all. Just write down the notes that is given at the end. It will help you out in preparing the answers in your internal assessments. And I hope it will be very easy to score marks. Thank you. If you have liked my video, please hit the like button and also comment if you have any questions from the chapter. Share it with your friends so that they can also benefit from this class.